In this tutorial, I'll walk you through the process of creating a realistic perfume bottle in Blender. You'll learn everything from adding a reference image, modeling, and texturing, to shading, lighting, and rendering the final image. I'll be demonstrating this process by recreating this image of a Labo perfume bottle, but this process will be very similar for any bottle. Start by deleting everything, and then adding the reference image to the ZY plane. Turn off render visibility and adjust opacity. Shift A to add a cylinder, and scale it to the size of the bottle's body. By pressing S, followed by Z, I am able to scale the cylinder in the Z direction only. In edit mode, with the top loop selected, use the S, E, and G keys to extrude and scale the top of the bottle. I added some extra detail, but it won't be visible, so it isn't important. Now bevel the top to match the curve of the bottle. Add a solidify modifier to give the glass thickness. Select the outer surface of the bottle and hide it. Now select the inner surface and assign it to a new vertex group. This will make it easier to add a colored liquid later on. Press Ctrl B with the inner loop selected to bevel the bottom of the bottle to match the reference image. With the outer loop selected, use the E, S, and G keys to add some detail to the bottom of the bottle. Add a subdivision modifier and shade smooth. Repeat this process for the lid. Add loop cuts to keep the subdivision modifier from messing up the geometry too much. And lastly, scale another cylinder to the size of the inner straw. For the backdrop, I added a plane, scaled it, and extruded the back edge up. Then I beveled the corner and shaded it smooth. Make sure to name all the components in your model to stay organized. Now, add in a camera so that it points in the X direction. Adjust its focal length and move it back to roughly the right distance. Adjust the aspect ratio by adjusting the resolution. For the lighting, I like to pull out a new window so I can see what the rendered view will look like while I adjust the lights. I added a few area lights and adjusted their size and power. You can always go back and tweak the lighting if you're not happy with it. The lighting seems to be coming from the left in my reference image, so that's what I went for. Now go into the shading tab to start adding the materials and textures. For the bottle, I deleted the principled BSDF and replaced it with a glass BSDF. To add the colored liquid, in edit mode, add two materials and name them. Using the vertex group, select the inner surface and assign the inner material to it. Then select everything but the inner surface and assign the outer material to that. I can now adjust the inner and outer materials separately. Although I didn't show it here, I adjusted the IOR in the inner glass BSDF to be about 1.3 since it is simulating a liquid, and I left the outer one as it is. Don't forget to add the glass material to the straw as well. For the lid, I added a bump node attached to the normal, followed by a noise texture. Then a mapping node. And lastly, a texture coordinate. This string of nodes is quite versatile and can easily be used to create many different textures quickly. Experiment by adjusting the scale, detail, and roughness. The bump strength can also be adjusted to make the texture less noticeable. I adjusted the scaling in the Z direction to get a bit of a brushed metal look. Once I was happy with the texture, I copied the string of nodes to reuse for the background texture. By adjusting the same settings, I was able to get a completely different texture for the paper-like backdrop. I like to go back and tweak the lights once all the materials have been created. It's much easier to see how the lights will react to the real materials and see the reflections and shadows caused by the glass. To add the label, add in another cylinder and scale it to be a bit wider in diameter than the bottle, but make sure it is the same height as the label. Delete the top and bottom faces. Make a new material and add an image texture. Select an image of your label. To make the image fit the cylinder correctly, UV unwrap the cylinder. Go to the UV editor and scale the unwrapped cylinder so that it is the same height as the image. Use the shrink wrap modifier to make the label stick to the bottle. Select the bottle as the target object and add an offset so that the label doesn't clip through the bottle. Then shade smooth. It's just about time to render. Just set the render engine to cycles and adjust the settings, bring down the number of samples so you don't have to wait too long, and set the contrast to high. You can play around with the curves if you dare. Now hit render and wait. I'd love it if you could subscribe, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Until next time, keep designing.